Topher. I've been a web developer for 15 years? No, 20 years. More than 20 years. It's been a long time. My wife tells people I've been building websites since before there were pictures on the internet. I did straight HTML for a long time, and then CSS was invented. And then I did HTML and CSS for a while, and then PHP was invented. And then I did PHP, HTML, CSS for a while. And then in 2010, I switched to WordPress, and I haven't really looked back ever since. I've worked for two different VIP agencies building enterprise-level websites. I've built innumerable nonprofit and church websites, personal sites, things like that. So I've got experience on the high end and the low end. And today we're going to talk about the Transients API. How many people have no idea what Transients are in WordPress? Awesome. This is going to be a talk about caching. Who did not know about Transients but does know about caching? Alright, cool. So, Transients are caching. But it's a very specific type, and it's a very specific level of caching, and it can be very powerful, and it's extremely easy to do. The word transient means lasting only for a short time. You may have heard occasionally people refer to as transients. That means they're not going to stick around very long, they're going to move on. In WordPress, it's a bit of data cached for an indeterminate amount of time. Now I say indeterminate, not because you don't get to decide how long it's supposed to last, but because you don't get to decide necessarily how long it actually does last. There are many, many things that can destroy a transient. So you need to keep that in mind as we move forward. So there are two common use cases for transients. One of them is time-consuming queries. We'll take a look at what a really long query is in a few minutes. But, excuse me, if you have a database query that goes 5, 10 seconds, 15 seconds, that's just going to kill your website. So we want to use transients to cache that stuff. The other is remote data fetched via the HTTP API. So say you write a script that runs out to your favorite movie site and gets movie data and processes it and renders it on your web page. Rather than have your page run out to that remote site every page load, you cache that data in a transient, and then it just loads super fast. And you can set it to get new data every day, or once a week, or once a month, or whatever you want. Going out to the internet, getting stuff and bringing it back takes a long time. You can do better with a stored piece of data. So how do they work? Each transient has a name. You get to make it up. My movie data. My weather data. Whatever. Just make something up. When you need that data, you check to see if it exists locally in a transient. If it does, you use it and you move on. And it's just like normal. If it doesn't, then you generate the data, you run your script, your big horrible query, you go get your movie data, whatever, and then you set it for the next time. And then when the next time comes, you check for it again, and it's there, and just keep doing that process. Where are transients stored? I don't care. It doesn't matter. WordPress takes care of it for you. No, really. Where are they stored? So this is one of the really cool things about transients, in my opinion. This is what makes it an API instead of just caching. WordPress has the ability to work with some very low-level, system-level caching plugins, like Memcache, APC, and things like that. Things that make PHP run fast. We're not talking about page caching like W3 Total Cache or WP Rocket. This is actually making your system run faster. If these plugins are available on your system, the Transients API will use them. So that movie data you get remote it will store it in RAM, and it's really fast to get it out. You pull down an enormous amount of data from the database, it sticks it right in RAM, and you have it in 0.02 of a millisecond. It's incredible. If your system does not have these plugins, then it will store it in the database, in the options table. It's not nearly as fast as Memcache or something like that, but it is way faster than a miserable query or running out to the internet again. The cool thing is you don't have to do anything to set this up. It just does it. Now, WordPress has a whole bunch of caching plugins, WP cache get, WP cache set, but those only work with those caching level plugins, and if they don't have them, then the whole thing blows up. With Transients, it magically uses whatever is the best resource available. And that's what makes it special. So how is this magic accomplished? This is actually surprisingly simple. There are only three functions: set, get, and delete. If you set one that already exists, it updates it. So you don't even need an updater function. And using these functions, you simply ask for the data you want. If it's not there, you build it the same old-fashioned way you always have, and you just set it for next time. Let's take a look at how to do it for real. I'm really burning through this. This is not going to be a very long talk. I hope you have good questions. So this is a horrible query. This is not Transients. This is just a classic horrible query. We set our post status, publish. Our post type is a custom post type called coaches. And when I wrote this, it's not coaches like people who are coaching, it's more like motor coaches, campers, things like that. We're going to order by date. No found rows is true. Anybody not familiar with no found rows? This is amazing. All right. By default, when you do a MySQL query, it runs a big calculation to find out how many rows it finds so that you can do pagination. Next page, previous page, whatever. It's very time consuming. If you know you're not going to do pagination, say no found rows true, and it will not run that calculation. Boom, you're a lot faster. So, here's where it gets horrible. A meta query. Meta queries are slow, just inherently. Everybody knows it. It's just the way it is. So, I have a key. Is this coach already sold or not? Value on not exists. So I'm looking for coaches who do not have the sold switch turned on, which means they are not sold. They're available. Keeps my inventory only showing available things. Feature on exists. So not only do I want things that are for sale, I want the ones where I've checked the little featured box to say, look at this one, this is a cool one. And down there at the bottom, coaches query, WP query, args, and I run the query. And it comes back with an object, because that's what WP query does. Now this is going to take maybe a full second to run, which doesn't sound very long, but when we're talking hundreds of milliseconds, that's miserable. So here's the transient code. So remember I said the first thing you do is give a name? Right there. Dollar transient name, coaches. Now you can name that variable anything you want, of course. Then I try to get it. Dollar coaches is get transient, transient name. And here I test. If this is an object, or I'm sorry, if this is not an object, run the horrible query. Then save the query using set transient, and I give it the transient name and the query that I just ran. I got it right there. And then I use, or I set some time. Now WordPress has, see where it says hour and seconds? WordPress has 5 or 6 of those set up. In fact, they're so cool, I'm going to try and show you right now. So what we have here is minute in seconds, hour in seconds, day in seconds, week in seconds, month in seconds, and year in seconds. And you can see the little math they're doing right there. So I wanted 12 hours. So I did hour in seconds times 12. If I wanted a whole day, I would just do day in seconds and be done with it. This makes it a lot easier, or at least it, so you don't have to think about the math. The code sample that I wrote a year ago to do this actually did the math, and it was 60 times 60 times 12. Then these days you don't have to do that anymore. So then, once I've saved my query, I say coaches equals coaches query. What's interesting about this little last line here is it's not using my transient. It's using this data that I just grabbed, so that I'm not actually getting it back out of the database a second time because of the query. So now, at the bottom here, $coaches holds my data. And it may have gotten it way up here from the transient, or it may have gotten it right here from my query. I don't care. From here on out, everything's the same. I'm just looping through my coaches and printing my featured image and my title and blah, blah, blah. Now here's something that newbies always forget about. What if something changes? I've stored my coaches in a transient, and the boss goes in and changes the title of one, but it doesn't change on the homepage, because he changed the original source, and the homepage is pulling from the transient. You need to figure out a way so that the data is always fresh, even though it's cached. And there are a couple of ways to do it. One of them is to simply set a time for it to expire. Remember I said mine expired every 12 hours? Well, I could set it to expire every 5 minutes. And for 5 minutes, people are going to get a fresh one, or get the old one. And every 5 minutes, some poor slob is going to get a slow query and rebuild it. Or, in this case, I wrote a function called delete coach transient, and it accepts a post ID. And basically what this is going to do is wait for somebody to make a change, and when they do, blow away the transient. And then the first guy who comes in is going to have to do a slow query. Too bad for him. So the first thing we do is make sure that we're not doing post revisions. We don't want somebody to pull up a post and not change it, just sit there looking at it, and have WordPress be saving in the background, blowing away that transient over and over again. So we want to make sure that we're not looking at a post revision. Then, we declare our slug, we're looking at coaches, that's our custom post type. And then this adds the nonce to the post array. I'm not even sure why, but it does. And I wrote the code, and I don't even remember why it does that. Then right here we say, if slug is not the post type in the admin area, then just return. Don't do this. We want to be dealing with coaches. If we're looking at posts and pages and whatnot, run away. We just don't even want to be doing any of this. Our transient name is coaches. That has to match the one from before. And then right there we say, delete transient name. So, we're going to make sure it's not a revision. We're going to make sure we're on coaches. We're going to make sure that we're really on coaches. And then we're going to delete the transient. And then right here we have add action on save post, run this whole function. So, this actually runs every time somebody saves any kind of post. It just bails out at the appropriate time. And only deletes my transient if we're looking at coaches. So, back up here. There's a horrible query. We invent a name, and we try to get it. If it's not there, we save it, and we move on. sure that we are in the right place, and then we just run delete transient on the name, and it's gone. That's it. That's all there is to transients. Yes?
Thank you. You mentioned that some caching plugins handle this. Why were you writing this, or is this something that my caching plugin is likely handling in the same similar logic?
Yes. So there's a bit of a misunderstanding there. When I say plugin, I don't mean WordPress plugin. I mean Apache plugin or Nginx plugin.
So my host might be handling this.
Yes. So your host, the Transients API may be talking to your host and storing it in Memcache, or it may be storing it in the database.
But my host might let me run an S of it like this.
Yes.
But that's nice.
Well, you can write transients on your host all day long. How your host takes that data and stores it for you is up to them.
Thank you.
So there are a couple of things to remember that are important. You can store just about anything in a transient. I stored an object, which was the result of a WP query. Recently, I did a project where I did an ugly query, but then I took that data and I made a giant HTML table with lots of processing where I was parsing names and splitting variables and blah, 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 blah. And I actually put that HTML table into the transient post-processing. So it was just a big block of text. So when I wanted to print that HTML table, I just said, hey, print me a table, and it did. I could have stored the object and then recreated that HTML table every time in PHP, but just pulling it out and loading it on a page was faster than processing all the data and creating a 100-line HTML table. Transients are ethereal. Lots of things can delete them. Never assume they're there just because you set them. Always test. There are lots of plugins that will optimize your database. And one of the things they do is go to the options table and delete all transients. Because it makes your database table much smaller, therefore much faster. Boom, all your transients are gone. So you may remember in our code, the first thing we did is try to get the transient and then test. Do we have it? Yes or no? If you don't run that test, if you just assume it's there and try to use that variable, one of these days it's going to blow up because the transient's going to be gone. So always, always test for them. Think about how and when to invalidate them. Otherwise, you're stuck with cached content. This goes to that whole thing I was talking about right before I showed you the delete function. This is probably the most difficult part of transients, and it's not code at all. It's trying to understand your data. How long should it live? When should it die? How will it die? Will I kill it, or will I set an expiration date and hope that WordPress kills it? All of these things you have to think through and decide for yourself, for your piece of data. I can't tell you. In addition to an expiration date on a transient, you can set it to infinity. You can say, this should never die. There are some use cases for it. One of them being where I have manual delete. If nobody ever changes the coaches, I don't ever want it to go away. I want it to last forever. I only want it to go away when it's deleted by a person. But you have to be careful with that. There's an add-on in Jetpack that fights brute force. Before Jetpack bought it, it was another plugin. Somebody wrote it. I don't even know who wrote it. But it was making a transient for every hit on the website. And then it was figuring out if you were being DDoSed by counting those hits and say, oh, look, we're getting a lot of them right in a row. Well, a friend of mine was working on a site that was very slow, and he couldn't figure out why. It was obviously the database, and eventually he figured out that those transients were set to never expire. so that you can watch an IP address forever. But when a DDoS came in, it was registering, what, 1,000 hits a second? Is that unusual when you're under attack? That's 1,000 database rows per second for years. He deleted several million rows from his database, and everything was all better. Now that wasn't a security flaw, it was a performance flaw. The developer didn't think, someday, this data needs to die. How is it going to die? Who's going to kill it? How is it going to go away? Another interesting thing about transients is, if there's an expiration date, WordPress itself is the thing that removes it and deletes it. If WordPress doesn't run, it just sits there. It's WP cron that does it. And WP cron only runs when your WordPress page loads. So if you set a transient and WordPress never loads again, it's going to sit there in your database for the rest of eternity. Or until somebody tears down the database. Just something to think about. Something to remember, that WP cron is the thing that looks at the expiration date and actually tries to expire it. Some resources. Evan Williamson wrote a transient manager. Let's see if I can switch tabs here. It lists every transient currently stored in WordPress. And you may think, well, I haven't made any, so there aren't any. There are thousands of things that WordPress stores in transients. Has anybody ever used a plugin with a license key? The license key is not stored in your code. You put it in a little form field and save. That's stored in a transient. If you delete that transient, your license key is invalidated. You have to put the key in again. How long have you been logged in? How long has it been since your plugins were updated? How long has it been since we checked? How long has it been since WordPress was updated? How long has it been since we checked? Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of transients. And sometimes they can cause problems. If there's a new version of WordPress that comes out, and your version is not saying, hey, there's a new version, click to update, you might want to look at your transients, and it'll say that your WordPress update transient was corrupted somehow, or has an infinite expiration date, or something. So this is useful to just go through, look at them, you can edit them, you can delete them, all kinds of stuff. Delete expired transients. I would recommend doing this every now and again. Just because they're expired doesn't mean that they're deleted from the database. It just means that they're not valid anymore and they're not used. So you might end up with lots and lots of them. My function actually deleted the transient. If I had had an expiration date, but I never deleted it, it would just sit there. I doubt you'll ever run into the 5 million database rows like the other guy did, but you might end up with 10,000. Every now and again, fire up deleted or delete expired transients and just flush the database. Query monitor. This is a wonderful tool that does many, many things. But one of them is, it will show you what transients were set or updated in this page load. So if you're writing some code and you're like, boy, did my setter work or not? The query monitor will tell you, yes, this one was set to this value. And you can see what's going on as you move.
Reset the transient? But then you updated the query?
Right, yeah. So his question is, I've deleted the query. I'm counting on the next person with a web browser to recreate it for me. Should I create it myself? And the answer is, in many cases, yes. Where you can, you should. So that you don't stick some poor browser with a slow query. If you are able to regenerate it yourself, you should. My example is with locally fetched data. If you're getting data from a remote site, it's a lot easier to do because you know exactly what your data is going to be. So you can wrap that all up in a function that you can run immediately after delete. Yes?
Would you be able to use a cron job to refresh the data?
So the question is, can you use a cron job to refresh the data? Absolutely. In many of the common WordPress caching plugins like Rocket or whatever, they have a preload the cache button, and you can write your own for your transients and have it run on cron, and just say, delete the transient, set a new one, here's the data, and move on. And for time-based data, that looks great. If you're having a person delete it, then it's a little stickier because you don't know necessarily if they're doing a search or what variables might be involved. It depends on the data. Yes?
Transients remind me a lot of cookies.
Oh, yes.
Can you clarify that for me? What's the difference?
Sure. What's the difference between transients and cookies? Cookies are stored in the browser. Transients are stored on the server.
And that's better?
It depends on your need. A transient could not help you in any way with being logged into a website. That's for cookies. And a cookie, you would not want to store data in it. Because then you would be asking every person to store a copy. And you don't want that. You want that on your server.
Thanks.
Yes?
This might be obvious, but you mentioned that it might be worth using that plugin to delete expired transients.
Sure.
Why do you think they aren't deleted by default?
WordPress doesn't do that. I don't know.
Yep.
Somebody made that decision once. If you just set an expiration date, it doesn't automatically delete them. It's just the way it is.
I guess WordPress is always minimal, so expect you to write the code to kind of delete itself or whatever.
Right. Yep. Yes?
So, I think save post now has a new variation where you can say save underscore post for coaches and get rid of your site checking code there. So my question was, in your example where you not only did the transient, but you pre-rendered the content in the HTML table and then showed that the transient, is that essentially not the same thing as the caching and normal caching?
Similar, but it's, they call it micro-caching. You're storing a blob.
This feed is a piece of the page.
Right. So, if you were not running a page cacher of any kind, my thing would still be cached, and so you'd still get the speed boost. Yes?
This is awesome. Thank you. It seems like a lot of this is going to have a lot of boilerplate over. If you want to sprinkle in a couple of transients, you're just going to repeat.
Yep.
Do you know of any sort of either like another plugin or some kind of way to go about like generalizing so that you're not just doing the same code over and over again, or do I just need to kind of write them out?
Yeah, I don't know very much. Mark Jaquith did some experiments, but he didn't use transients. He used the caching plugins directly. So you would have to rewrite it for transients. But I don't think I've seen very much boilerplate to simplify this. You're pretty much stuck writing your own. Yes?
Do you recommend incorporating a version number in the transient name in the case where you're modifying the composition of that query as you go through cycles of development?
Yeah. So the question is, should there be a version number in the transient name? I've never done it. I suppose you could come up with a use case for it. In my case, I'm reusing the same one over and over, so I only ever have one row. In your case, you would end up with a new row for every one, which might be absolutely appropriate. depending on what you're doing, I don't know.
If it were... In the case you're testing, do you change the query?
Yep, testing would be...
You're getting the old transient value, not the new query definition.
Yeah, testing would be an appropriate instance. You could just use a little PHP to put the date, time, stamp in your transient name, and it would make a new row every time instead of updating the old one. And then you could be loading the database in another app and be watching your rows appear and see what the data is. So testing would be a good use case for that, sure. Yeah?
So you have the save post function to delete it.
I'm sorry, can you move on?
You have the save post function to delete the transient, but just to clarify, if I were to view the page on my own, would it recreate that transient, or do I have to be logged out? Is there any...
No, it would recreate it instantly.
Okay. So I could be the portion of that gets the first query load, so I'm checking that first.
Yep, absolutely. Okay.
Do you have any thoughts on a strategy for doing a transient for a part of a page where the user maybe has control from filtering or something? So if your coach is going to be filtered by their feature set, and I want to transient to store all the variations on the theme or permutations?
So the question is, well, this particular query I had was really the result of a search. I'm searching for on and featured. So his question is, can you have multiple queries for different types of searches? And absolutely, you can build the transient name off the variables from the form and dynamically create as many possible permutations as there are. So that would allow you to make transients for all the different searches.
Right.
But you don't necessarily magically know the names of all of those because they were dynamically created. So you have to use regular expressions to delete those transients on save. And I can imagine how that would be done, but I couldn't write that code right now.
Yeah, so the first gap is easy to clean up.
Exactly.
Maybe just do a short place.
Yeah. Yes.
Is it a good idea then to put every custom query in a transient? Like all the queries we do in different pages, is that a good idea? Or would be that a performance if we start to use transient everywhere?
I'm not sure I understand. There's a bit of an echo. You're asking, can you store all your queries in there?
Yeah. Is that a good idea?
Yes. You could store every query you do in a transient. And if you're using a caching plugin like Memcache on the system side, that would absolutely be beneficial. Because storing all that in RAM is going to be way faster than talking to the database. If you store a simple query result in the database, then you're still making a simple database call to get it. And it probably just evens out. That said, if you're writing for an unknown audience, like not your own server, you're going to put it on .org or something, you have no idea what they're doing. And so it couldn't really hurt anything to wrap all of them in transients. And then for those special people who have the amazing caching plugins, their site's super fast. And everybody else is the same. It couldn't hurt to write them all that way. Yes?
I just thought of a really good question on the deleting the transients. Because I used to use Redis like a long time ago. You can do that like wildcard from the thing. So Stack Overflow is a really good one. That's like a really simple, just a query. They should implement it as one of the features, but you could do it with a one-liner.
Oh, that's true. You could do it easily with a database call. Because they're just stored in the app. Well, okay. Unless they're stored in Memcache. If they're not in the database, then you're stuck.
That's a good point.
Yeah, I think it's a very use case driven thing, right? So if you have something that's fairly static, you can just clear all the related transients and not worry about it every time. But if you have something where it's like inventory levels, changing dynamically for different
iterations.
You want something more elaborate.
back to the question that was posed two questions ago. Would a possible use case be if you had a date, month, year archive?
Uh-huh.
So you're using really the same template for all those queries.
Is using only which?
Using the same template for all those different permutations of the query.
I still can't hear very well. Is there a microphone back there?
Yep.
Awesome.
So I was wondering if you were doing like a month, date, year archive, which uses the same template, but it's just a different query string, got bird parameters. Could you use a transient for each permutation? So for like March 24, 2019, all the results associated with that. And then you would store as a transient name, transients 324 2019.
I'm still not hearing you. I'm sorry. I'm getting old.
So I'm wondering if you're doing like a month, date, year archive, but they're all using the same templates. Would that be a use case for naming transients a unique name? So it would be transients underscore 324-2019 for that set of results.
Sure.
Would you do something like that?
Yeah, you could do that. You could pre-declare all the possible variations, and then you would know what they all are.
Or you could just concatenate them dynamically.
Yeah. Okay. That'd work. Yeah, go ahead.
Thanks. So most sites have, or at least larger sites have, layers of caching, right? Like you're not just...
Boy, I can't hear that at all. I think all the speakers are pointed that way.
Okay. Is this better?
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay, cool. So most sites, at least larger sites, have layers of caching, right? You're not just running one type of cache, right? So I'm wondering, do you frequently see a need when you are storing values of transients of, and then you change that, you delete the transients, store a new value in it, frequently see the need to invalidate other caches? Like, I could foresee a scenario where you store a new value in a transient, but if you have a persistent cache on the front of the garnish or something like that, it might still be serving up an old value, right? Do you often see the need to invalidate other caches when you're changing transient values?
So if I understand you, you're asking about you've got transients, but you're also doing page cache?
Right.
Yeah. That's a tricky thing, and if you're writing for yourself, then you can fiddle with cache times and say my page cache must delete every so often. Or you can even get really fancy and make your delete function also delete your page cache. If you're writing a plugin for .org or something, then you don't know, and I'm not sure there's a whole lot you can do about it. I've worked with some plugins that deleted page cache. There's an SEO plugin in Round with Toast that deleted a page cache on save, but like for the entire website. And there was a bug so that it was actually running on wp-cron, so it was wiping out my page cache every 15 seconds or so. So you want to be extraordinarily careful with that kind of thing. I like the idea, if you're writing for yourself, WP Rocket has hooks for deleting page caches. If you're writing for yourself, then incorporate that into your delete function, and it'll just refresh itself in the next one. Oh, and it looks like I'm done. All right, I'm going to hang out in the happiness bar, so if you have more questions, we can go shoot the breeze about caching.